All right, everyone, welcome back to Let's Play This Is the Police. So apparently zoo animals are starving, so, you know, I personally want to go and beat the owners of that zoo senseless. Toilets stolen from City Hall. So that's fairly entertaining, I like that. Freiburg host to greatest lasagna in history. I'd like to know a little bit more about what exactly they mean by that, but, you know, whatever. Oh, I'm in a pretty good mood today. Oh, what's this? My neighbor died and his wife asked me to help with the funeral arrangements. Can I take the day off? He does have one energy tick away, so we'll grant him that, yeah. Alright, and then we still have our three detectives. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 cops. So hopefully that will be enough for the day. And I think we bought everything, haven't we? Yeah. Okay. So let's go ahead and use this. I like this one. And I think this one, like that particular detective is off today, isn't he? Yeah. Okay. And what's this? A man took his dog out for a walk and upon returning home noticed a crouched hooded figure fumbling with a car at the end of the street. Alright. Let's go ahead and send a couple of cops down there, have them deal with that. I think this is an interesting look at the way, like, oh, shit. I think this is an interesting look at the way, different things that cops have to deal with, and the juggling priorities, and the short on manpower. A man with dilated pupils boarded a bus and then pulled out a gun, possibly fake. He's demanding that the bus immediately leave for Africa. So he's high as a kite. The gun could be fake, so I don't really want to send the SWAT team yet, although we can use them up to 3 times a day, so I guess that doesn't really matter. We'll send 2 cops in the SWAT team, since I can't send a huge amount of people, I might as well send the SWAT team with them. Oh, attempted carjacking. Yay, everyone was unharmed and the person was caught. So, I mean, I think this is a pretty interesting look. At the same time, like, while this is entertaining, I mean, we're about, 30 days in, so I think it's day 27 is what we're at. And so that means we are 1/6 of the way in. An anonymous call came in. Hello, I have information about a missing girl named Lisa Pettigrew. Is that what that says? Yeah, Pettigrew. Lisa Pettigrew. I kidnapped her a week ago, but now she's ready to go home. You can find her at the True Color Hotel, room 180B. You'd better hurry if you want to see her alive. Alright. So unfortunately, the SWAT team is out handling stuff, so we'll send 3 cops. Oh, and now the SWAT team is back. Should have let it go on for a little bit, but you know, if they need more cops, I'll get one of those messages. Chances are I'll just have to make some decisions. A passerby reported that he saw a motorcyclist pull up to a gas station carrying a gun. He entered the station without removing his helmet. He then heard screams and gunshots. Oh, joy. So, room 180B is located on the top floor of the hotel. A red... what is that saying? A red ball is hanging from the doorknob. And the words written on the red... on the ball read, "Call the bomb squad." Well, this could very well be a prank. There may not be a bomb in there, but I'm not about to put my cops at risk. So... Okay, no. Well, based on these options, personally, I would call the bomb squad, but based on these options, we'll enter through the hotel's roof. Inside is a standard motel room, complete with bed, bedside table, telephone, and TV. The curtains are drawn, and sitting on the bed is a girl strapped with explosives. Red and yellow wires protrude from the bomb. Exit the room, evacuate the hotel, and wait for the bomb squad. No, we're gonna... I hope the little girl doesn't die. Yay! So I think this really rewards you for acting based on police protocol. And thankfully, because I watched a ridiculous amount of Law & Order SVU, I know I have some idea of what these would be. And plus, I mean, that's also kind of common sense right there. At the end of a high school reunion party, a naked young man entered the restaurant with an object in his hand vaguely resembling a gun. He was behaving very erratically, then jumped up on the table and started threatening the restaurant's patrons. So we only have two cops, so we'll send everything at it. And I hope to God I don't need that soon. Oh, shit! Awesome. So I just lost another cop. Sorry, man. So we're 1/6 of the way in, and I have $80,000, so, I mean, that's probably a little under where we want to be, but chances are more options are going to come up. Oh shit, massive fight. Okay, Freeburg lost to Pittsville 12-0. And the local fans are furious. They are screaming and swearing, and the visiting team as they retreated to their locker room. Himself enraged by the insults, the visiting team's captain threw his stick and struck one of the fans in the face. A massive brawl erupted involving fans, players, referees, and even the concession hawkers. Wonderful. Don't you love humanity? Alright, so unfortunately, like, I don't have that much, and I need to keep at least two officers for another call, so all I can send, and the SWAT team has already been deployed, and so is the paddy wagon, so, like, I fucked us. I'm so sorry, you guys. Nothing can be seen from the street, but screams and the sound of smashing plates can be heard from within. Restaurant is surrounded. Go through the entrance. Try to enter. We'll use the megaphone. When the young man spots the police, he grabs a woman and puts a gun to her head. He yells something unintelligible and squeezes his hostage's neck. His gun appears to be a toy. Let's all come down, talk this out. Pounce on the criminal. I don't think it's a good idea to casually approach, because, I mean, even if his gun is a toy, he could still do something very fucking stupid and very drastic. Yes. So those two are now coming back. I'm kind of surprised that this game has you literally go day by day with these. So you end up doing about 6 months worth of dispatching. Alright, we will clear all slots and let's just add two to that. Because again, this is why I spare the two. A taxi driver called from a payphone complaining that a violent customer refused to pay the fare and attempted to leave the car. When the cab driver locked the door, the man went berserk and broke the car's safety screen and attempted to strangle the driver. The driver managed to escape, but the assailant remains locked inside the car. Well, I'm going to send one cop. I really don't like being the short-staffed. I have five cops handling some fucking bullshit.
412A.
Oh, wow. That was quick. I'd like to know what's happening, with the massive fight. Bender caught. No one was... yay! Oh my god, that's a surprise, but I'm very happy. And wow, it's suddenly dead quiet. And it's the end of the day. So there we go. Need to file some paperwork on a dead employee. We are going to, for once, delay the paperwork and see how it goes. Hopefully I'm not, like, royally screwing us over. Drunk student falls from fifth floor window injured. Well, yeah, I would assume so. Accident at the reservoir. Water runs out in 2 days. That's scary. This fall, record rainfall in Freiburg. So then those two don't 100% match, but maybe, I don't know. We'll find out. If it's something that will affect us, we'll find out about it. Today, my daughter's daughter is opening an art exhibition at the Elite Gallery in a nearby city. Can I have the day off? It seems to constantly be trying to get the day off. I will grant it this time, though. And, I can give out Stripe. I like getting everyone, like, up as high as they can possibly go, and then moving on to the next person.
You know when a police chief really feels his power? When he hires and fires people? When he throws folks in jail? When he's bossing everyone around all morning? No, there's no power there. Just bureaucratic red tape. Like directing traffic. Not that it's all bad. No, I feel it the most when people come to me with accusations. Accusations happen outside the law. They don't need to be rational or supported by evidence. They don't petition justice in the careful words of legal formality. No, an accusation is a personal cry, full of resentment or envy, a defeated moan or an angry howl. The accuser rarely imagines you'll share their resentment, their envy, their hatred. No, but they do imagine that your love of power is so strong that you'll leap to decide the fates of others, happy just to take someone's word for the facts. Businessmen accuse the gangsters blame our public figures denounce politicians, the politicians point to the businessmen. When it comes to accusation, there's only one rule. Don't aim too high. If you overestimate your own importance, then complaining can cost you your life. So choose the easier path. Exaggerate as far as you can. And try to make your plea sound as sad and pathetic as possible. The accusation I received today sure didn't fit the normal mold. After killing Vikas Varga and routing his supporters, San further strengthened his already powerful authority. Even a month ago, anyone coming out against San would sound like a lunatic with a death wish. Today, it's the same thing as suicide. But the letter I'm holding in my hands directly connects Henry Sand, lieutenant of the Sand Mafia family, to the reported death of successful banker John Pazzi. Henry has a daughter, Marianne, a dancer, and apparently it all started with her. One day, Marianne danced in the title role of a production of Giselle, and Henry, proud father that he is, brought the whole family to the premiere, along with some of the family's business partners. Among their guests was the young banker John Pazzi. He couldn't keep his eyes off Marianne, but she ended up brushing him off. In response, Pazzi ambushed her one night after rehearsal, pulled her into his limousine, and had his way with the poor girl. After that, gentleman that he was, he drove the girl home and threatened that if she told anyone what happened, her mother would get the same treatment. But her father still managed to shake the truth out of Marianne, and he decided to take his revenge. Of course, Henry knew he couldn't just go with his instincts and put a bullet in Pazzi in broad daylight. The rich bastard was too important for business, and Henry is neck deep in the family business, overseeing transportations for the San Mafia. He knew about every delivery delay, every car, and every shop. It was mostly thanks to Henry that the whole sand operation rolls so smoothly. Henry has free access to all their off-book cars, and a tar-black motive. Yeah, he could easily arrange the death of John Pazzi as a drunken, late-night hit-and-run. But Henry Sand is smarter than that. If this story about Pazzi is true, he'd more likely go to the boss and ask permission. I'd have figured this letter the ramblings of a retired gangster looking to spice up his life with little excitement. The way the letter started, "My dear little old copcake," I had every mind to toss it in the trash. But something else got my attention. They're rarely ever signed. But this one ended, "Robespierre," and I doubt it's an imposter. No one would go against the most powerful group in the city, hoping to hide behind the name of some prankster clown. Like everyone else, I had no idea who Robespierre was or what he wanted. But there was no doubt that this guy was more than a little crazy. An arrogant psychopath. Could be dangerous. Definitely worth looking into.